Guess who's rescuing animals again?
I promised to update you guys on the rescued bunnies. I rescued 3 baby bunnies back in July. One of them had both ears chewed off. The other 2 had 1 ear chewed off each. They were malnourished. They ended up going to an amazing rabbit rescue. Well, let me reintroduce them to you. The biggest one was Helen. The second largest and the one that seemed to be doing the best of the 3, I named Vincent. And the smallest one and the one that seemed to be doing the poorest is Georgia. When they got to the rescue, they were assessed there, but then they soon went to an actual vet. They were all confirmed to be girls, so I missexed Vincent. So Vincent's name was changed to Vinny. They figured out that Georgia and Helen both had severe teeth issues. There was a misalignment with Georgia's jaw, almost like it had been broken at some point. He also discovered that she had developed an infection in her jaw from whatever injury or genetic deformity she had. They had to go back to the vet several times to reaffirm what was wrong with Georgia and with Helen because they were in the most severe shape. Here are some amazing photos that the rescuer got. These 3 sisters just loved each other to death and they snuggled in the most adorable ways. The first tragic blow was when little Georgia passed away. It was right after she seemed to be doing better, and then suddenly she went downhill and it was over for her. In a way, I was relieved to hear it because she was suffering and I couldn't imagine the pain she was in, and now she's free of that. People don't realize that rabbits grieve when they lose their buddies. So I was really worried of how this would affect the 2 others. The other 2 seemed to be doing really good though. They kept going back for vet visits. Helen had to get her teeth trimmed. Turned out that she had an infection too in her jaw, the same as Georgia's, just not as far along. To all of our surprise, she ended up passing away as well. I was really, really sad to hear about Helen passing away, especially because that meant that Vinny was now alone. Vinny turned out to have teeth problems too, just not as severe as her sisters. She had to go in at least every 2 weeks to get her teeth trimmed. I believe at some point, I'm not sure if this has already happened or is going to happen, but she was due to get her incisors pulled out completely. Other than that, Vinny amazingly thrived. She would flop around and sleep in the cutest position. They gave her teddy bears to help her cope with the loss of her sisters. Her teeth issues were nothing like what her sisters had. It's funny because when I had them for that brief time, Vinny was the one that impressed me the most. She was actually my favorite, to be honest. Vinny has grown up into the most beautiful bunny. The fact that she's missing an ear doesn't even really register when you see pictures of her. The gray on her ears and her nose have darkened into this beautiful dark smoke gray color. She's such a trooper. I am so thrilled that at least one of the bunnies that I rescued has survived. And I really do feel very hopeful about her future. There were some incredibly generous people that donated to their GoFundMe page. I strongly encourage you, if you are looking into owning your own rabbit, to check into rescues and shelters, because there are so many rabbits that are neglected or abused or surrendered. I'm just so happy that Vinny has made it and she's beautiful. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you in my next video.